Hi, welcome back to It's a Miracle Beauty. My name is Brandy and I am a beauty review channel. As you saw from the title today, I am reviewing my Birchbox. This is June 2020. So I had posted my May and I did advise. I had took a year off of Birchbox and I'm just now going back. I did do a 90-day subscription and I'll kind of feel it out and see if I want to continue it at that point. Doesn't seem to be a lot of interest in this box, so if that's something you don't want to see, if you do me a favor and just put no in the comments down below, that way I know not to waste my money or my time with these, as they are sample sizes. I have plenty of full sizes I can use. I would rather do something that you want to see. So if you don't mind doing that, I'd appreciate it. Just put a quick yes or no down in the box on whether you'd like to see future Birchboxes. If you like unboxings and mystery boxes, tutorials, or reviews, I hope that you will like, share, subscribe, ring the bell for notifications, and let's get into the June 2020 Birchbox. So Birchbox does give you a card with the full size prices on it, and they do give these Birchbox tips, which they were not doing this when I got the box before, so I think it's a cool thing. So this one is Birchbox tip 148. It says, everybody needs you time, indulge a little. And I think that's so true. Absolutely, these days, so true. The first thing I see is kind of an interesting one because I literally just got a sample of this from Sephora, but it was like not a sample, like Birchbox sample. It was like an individual, like one use. So this is the Amika Flash Instant Shine Mask. The full size price of this is $25. It doesn't give me the ounces, but this one's really neat. So I want to read the directions to you because it's kind of a neat of how it works. It says, to quickly deliver moisture and shine, squeeze out excess water from hair, then apply product in sections to fully saturated mid-length to ends. Wait 60 seconds, then rinse. So I actually did this, and this was like 2 weeks ago, and I still have like a ton of shine left in my hair. It reminds me of the Olaplex products where you put them in, and then you actually do your normal hair routine, and it just seals and bonds the hair. So this is one I actually had on my list to purchase the full size, so I'm actually kind of excited that I got that in this box. And $25 for the full size does not sound bad to me. I don't know how many uses are in the full size. I will need to kind of look at that, but I definitely think that that's really reasonable. So the next thing is the Benefit Give Me Brow. I currently own this. It does look like this. I'm not going to open it because it is shade 4.5. I'm like a 1 or a 2, depending on if I have blonde in, all of that. So that's not going to work. This is 4.5 is neutral deep brown. So I will set that aside. And I have some girlfriends that we trade products that we get in boxes. So I will put that in a trade bin for them. So the next thing I see, this was my choice product and I was super excited. I didn't realize something when I picked it. However, I'll explain. This is the Radiant Glow Highlighter by IBY. So like 2 years ago, I got a Prosecco IBY highlighter and I literally used it till there's nothing left in it. Like the lid broke off. It's the same container too. That's what's funny. The lid broke off. It was just crazy how I just wore this little bitty sample, but I loved it. First of all, I truly did have a lot less highlighters at that point, but it also was just a clean highlighter I could wear at work. I wasn't glowing to the moon. Like, it was just a really cute highlighter. So this one is the IBY, and this one is in 24K Magic. Just look like this. And this, I think, is going to be too dark for my skin. Oh, maybe I could use it if I get a little bit of sun. Right now, I am really fair. So if I get a little bit of sun, I think that would be usable. So the full size of that is only $14. I don't think that's bad at all. IBY is an indie brand, so I think that's great. At least I think they are. Fill me in down below. So the next one is the Marcel Micellar Water. Micellar? That just invented a new word. Marcel Micellar Water. Does look like this. And this retails for $17 normally. It does not give me the full ounces, so I'm not sure. This one is a 1.7 ounce, but I don't know how much the full size is. It doesn't tell me on here, which that's one thing I wish they would say, like full size, X number of ounces, because I do a lot of math to figure out the ounces, to see if it's a good value or not. So next thing is the Oribe Dry Texturizing Spray. I actually love this stuff. This, and I recently got a dry shampoo, and it worked really well. I really liked it. I have super, super like pencil fine hair. So these thickening and texturizing sprays typically kind of give me just a little bit of volume. So I look like, you know, I actually have hair instead of flat stuff going on. So I'm excited about that. The retail price of the full size? $48. Nope, never gonna happen, but I will keep getting these and I'll be just fine with it. The last thing is, and it does say this is a sample, not a trial or travel. So this is the Alterna My Hair, My Canvas, Me Time Everyday Shampoo and Conditioner. Does look like this. So if you haven't watched any of my videos before, I do put values on things by what they are and how we receive them. So like, for example, these three items, I would put $3 on them, and the IBUI, I would put $3 on them because they're sample size. They're not one-time use, but they're not a full travel size either. So I do put $3 on that. So we have, let's see, five items times three, that's 15, that paid for the box. I do put $1 per actual physical one-use sample. It's actually 17. That pays for the box and it's a wash. And then the one item I'm not able to use due to that shade, I'm actually gonna trade for something else. We actually, palettes we don't want, or face products, skin products, whatever, we just kind of trade. There's a three of us that just trade around, and that way our products aren't going to waste sitting there and we don't have to find a home for them. So this is one that I knew someone wanted, so I am throwing it in the trade bin. So, and if not, I can donate it to our local shelter too. So that is my Birchbox for June 2020. Honestly, me, my reaction, I'm happy with this box. Am I in love with every product? No. And the main thing is micellar water to me is something you can buy at the corner store, and you can get, you know, Garnier or one of them. And then the IBUI is a shade that I think will be kind of a struggle for me to use. So that one I'm a little disappointed in, but I should have read it before I picked it. That could have been why it's too dark. Maybe I picked the wrong shade because I believe there was more than one. I think I was so excited to see the IBUI highlighter. It's like, I want that, and didn't even read. But for me, the two items that really like make the entire box are these two hair products, the Amika and the Rebe. I love those products already, and I don't have to go invest in them right now. It gets me another time period until I actually need them. So that is my Birchbox June 2020. So one more time, if you wouldn't mind posting down below in the comment box, yes or no, if you want future Birchbox videos. And then if you do like unboxings, mystery boxes, reviews, and collabs, I hope that you will like, share, subscribe, ring the bell for notifications, and I hope I see you again soon.